guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I decided to share with you guys some information related to MBA programs in Poland. I have got a lot of questions regarding this in my previous video. If you haven't watched my previous video regarding studies in Poland, it's here. Go watch it first and then come back to this video for more information about MBA programs. Okay, so I got a few questions regarding studies in Poland, so I decided to share the answers for these questions through this video. So if you're interested, keep watching. It's all about MBA programs in Poland and my personal experiences when I was applying to the universities here. The first question was, is it good to do MBA programs in Poland? To answer this question, let me list down five best courses to do in Poland. The first being MBBS, second being Engineering and Technology, third being MBA and Management, the fourth being Business and Economics, and the fifth being Aviation. So the answer to the first question is, of course, yes. Okay, so some of the possible advantages of doing masters in Poland is that there is no strict rules that you need to learn Polish. There are a lot of international students here and some of the Polish students also speaks English. So there are no strict rules that you need to learn Polish. And the second best part is that there are more than 16 programs taught in English. And the third one is that you don't need to crack any entrance examinations to enter any of the Polish universities. Okay, so there are some top universities in Poland to do your master's program, some of which includes Poznan University of Economics, the second one is University of Warsaw, third one is Warsaw University of Technology, they have their business school, and many more. I will list down the link to these universities down in the description box, which would be helpful for you guys to search on them. And the main idea is that it's always best that you do your bachelor's and master's in a public university if you're coming to a European country, because when it comes to certification and other things, public universities are 10 times better than the private universities, but there are also some good private universities that you can choose from. So the next question is, do we need any English proficiency certificates like IELTS, TOEFL, etc.? So the answer to this question is, it varies for master's degree, but for a bachelor's degree it is not necessary. All you need to submit is a certificate showing that you did your high school in English. But for master's degree, it varies depending on the university you choose. Some universities require IELTS or TOEFL, whereas some they just need a certificate showing that you did your bachelor's in English. So the best way to apply to these universities is by shortlisting the university that you want to study and then checking on to the entry requirement, where they will mention all the documents that you need to submit. And yeah, that's it. There was a lot of questions where they asked, how did I come to Poland? So the answer is, I applied to an agency and they found out this university for me, and I had to submit a few documents as I mentioned in my previous video. Also, I didn't have to submit any English proficiency certificate like IELTS or TOEFL, because I did my high school in English and that was all I needed. And I'm not doing my master's, I'm doing my bachelor's, so because of that I didn't have to submit any of the English proficiency certificates. Okay, so the next question was regarding the student visas in Poland. They wanted to know if there is any age limit, like if that person is about 30 years, will he get a student visa? And yeah, there was some similar questions like that. So the main idea behind a student visa is that you get a letter from the university telling that you are a student of that university doing master's or bachelor's. So if you have that certificate, that would be enough for you to get a national visa, along with other documents of course, which will include your passport copy and many more things. The visa is valid for almost 1 year. For me it is valid only for 8 months. I don't know why, but maybe I think it depends on your luck too. So after coming to Poland, you can apply for your temporary residence, which is your TR. This would be valid for another 1 to 3 years and you can keep renewing it. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope I answered all kind of questions. If there is any more questions, please put them down in the comment section. I'll try my maximum to answer it. Down in the description box, I will put some links to some of the best universities in Poland to do your MBA program. And yeah, that's pretty much it for today's video. I hope you guys found this informative. If you found it informative, don't forget to give me a thumbs up for my research work. And yeah, share it with your friends who are planning to pursue their higher education in Poland. And yeah, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and press the bell icon to get notified whenever I upload a new video every week. Until next time, God bless.